CQDX, CQDX, CQDX. This is Havana calling. CQDX, CQDX, CQDX. This is Radio Havana calling all shortwave listeners and radio amateurs. Welcome to... DXers Unlimited, Radio Havana's weekly feature dedicated to the fascinating world of radio communication.
Hi, mis amigos radio aficionados all around the world now listening to this, the middle of the week edition of DXers Unlimited, undoubtedly your favorite radio hobby program, now just a few days away from celebrating a new anniversary of the Onda Corta Experimental Cubana, the Cuban experimental shortwave station that went on the air on the 24th of February of 1961 to mark the beginning of a new era in international broadcasting, when a small nation like Cuba started this project to put forward the truth about the Cuban Revolution on the world's short airwave. As always, it's a great pleasure for me to share with you the most up-to-date radio-related information, answer your questions, and provide our exclusive and non-copyrighted high-frequency plus low-band VHF propagation updates and forecasts that have proven to be so useful for DXers and amateur radio contest operators all around the world. I am Arnaldo, Arnie Coro, Radio Amateur Field 2KK, that's my ham radio call sign, Charlie, Oscar 2, Kilo Kilo, and here is item 1 of this program. Solar Cycle 24, well, I saw the daily solar plus drop below 70 units today, Tuesday, and if this trend keeps up, we're going to see a very low nighttime maximum usable frequency, especially on propagation paths from east to west for the next several days. The nighttime maximum usable frequency may drop even below 6 MHz some days. Item 2, also related to high frequency and low band VHF propagation conditions, expect coming up more E-short skip propagation beginning starting around late April. Sporadic E-short skip. Several days, especially if the solar flux continues to move down, it's going to happen. A long-time analysis of sporadic E-layer events does point toward a certain degree of what's known statistically and scientifically as inverse correlation with solar activity. The lower solar activity, the more chances of sporadic E events, according to that research project. Item 3, coming up when after a special short interval, musical interval, and then the program will follow up. Now this is item 3 of today's show. Many DXers and the listeners that write me via email keep commenting about how they first learned about the radio hobby. And in some instances, and to our satisfaction, my personal satisfaction, they report that coming across quite a chance with this show on the shortwave led the way into a long-lasting enjoyment of this wonderful way of spending our spare time, that's playing with our wonderful radios. Among those writing was listener Gordon from Nebraska, USA, that told me in his email that last Sunday he was listening using a minimum pass count regenerative receiver, solid-state radio, that he built following the circuit diagram and instructions sent to him several years ago from my email account. He even sent a copy of the original email I sent him years ago. Gordon adds that he has passed along the .pdf file to several friends who wanted to build the little radio after he had demonstrated how well it worked at a radio club meeting recently by adding a very simple and also easy to build two-stage audio amplifier to the little receiver to provide higher headphone volume while the current drawn from the receiver battery doesn't increase significantly. My collection of homebrew solid-state radios recently grew again once more when a listener from Australia sent the circuit diagram of a receiver originally published by the British GQRP Club, the GQRP Club magazine, and using the name Club, under the name of the HF9 radio. I'm now gathering the parts to build a replica of that circuit diagram that, according to amigo Ian from Australia, Australia, provides amazing performance from the AM broadcast band and up to this amateur assembly band with good band spread. Stay tuned for more radio related information direct and from the source coming to you from Sony Havana, Cuba. Back in a few seconds, I'm on the call. Yes, mis amigos, this is the middle of the week program of DXers Unlimited, your favorite radio hobby program, and here's now one of your favorites, the antenna topic section of the show. Today I will describe a short form TTFD antenna, a tilted terminated foldable pole that amigo Gerald described as the pocket size version of the broadband antenna. It works very well from about 14 to 56 MHz, that's from 20 meters to 5 meters, and it's a very nice broadband antenna coverage by all standards. As a matter of fact, it's only 7.1 meters long. That translates into another length of about 23 feet. And because you normally install a TPMP as a slow-wave antenna, the actual footprint is still smaller. According to Gerald's practical experience from New York with this version of the TPMP, using a terminating resistor value of around 800 ohms for excellent reception is possible on the 20, 17, 15, 12, 10, and 6 meter amateur band. So the antenna is used for monitoring 6 amateur bands while using a single coaxial feed line to the radio. Another useful feature is the fact that after testing the antenna while transmitting on it, he found out that on the 15, 12, 10, and 6 meter bands, in comparison with a net of 4 half-wave dipoles, shows that this short TPFT provides practically the same signal report while transmitting on those 4 bands, 15, 12, 10, and 6 meters. He then added in his email that on the 20 meters and 17 meter bands, the short form TPFT described is probably about 3 dB or maybe more below the rip signal radiated by a dual half-wave dipole that is caught for the 20 and 17 meter bands used as a comparison antenna. Amigo Gerald added that he recommends this version of the TPFT to be installed using a mast of less than 6 meters high, that's 21 feet or more, even farther if possible. His antenna slopes down to a shorter mast at a 45 degrees sloping angle. And he found out, he tells me, that it behaves as an omnidirectional system, not showing a particular directivity. Well, another thing, Gerald's amateur radio station maximum power output is around 70 watts. He was able to home brew the 800 ohm terminating resistor using non-inductive resistors made of carbon connected in a series and parallel combination, providing around 800 ohms at a power dissipation of 50 watts. The coaxial feed line in use is the standard low-cost 75 ohms cable used for TV set antennas. It's a coaxial cable known as type RG6. By the way, my early version of this antenna was built in a hurry for a contest station, started to show problems after about 6 months of exposure to our high tropical weather and very high ultraviolet radiation received on the antenna from the sun here in Cuba. So that's another thing to take care of. So if you want to learn more about the 6-band 14 to 56 MHz broadband antenna, just send me an email to info@enet.cu. And I'd be very happy to send you the .pdf file with complete information and some photos. There are no hard-to-find materials involved, so the project can be completed even during a single weekend. But do remember to follow my advice and properly seal the loading resistors and the balloon from the weather by using proper weather protection procedures. And now, as always at the end of the show, DXers Unlimited is coming to an end with Arnie Gordo's DXers Unlimited High Frequency Propagation Update and Forecast. The sun is totally black. Tuesday morning, the face of the sun, black again, the afternoon sunset, heralds the approach of solar minimum. And by the way, space weather changes during solar minimum include that the cosmic rays do increase, Earth's upper atmosphere cools and shrinks, and aurora borealis may change color. Expect an abrupt drop in the nighttime maximum usable frequency, the MUF frequency, after about 2 hours following the local sunset. And someday, this may be a very low maximum usable frequency during the evening. Also, take into consideration the daytime maximum usable frequency curve will peak at much lower values than during the days when the solar flux was around the 120 magic figure mark. At 6 meter operators call that number, 120 solar flux, it's magic. See you all the weekend edition of the DXers Unlimited next Sunday and Monday. And remember to send your signal reports, your radio hobby questions, and comments to our program to info@enet.cu. Enet is Echo November Echo Tango dot Charlie Uniform. info@enet.cu or via mail to Arnie Coro, Radio Havana Cuba, Havana, Cuba.
And that's all for today. This is Arnie Coro, Radio Amateur CO2KK, your host here at Radio Havana's DXers Unlimited, saying 73 and very good DX.
Thanks, Arnie. Arnie Coro with DXers Unlimited, heard every week here on RHC. Also on the middle of the week, Tuesdays and Wednesdays, UTC days, you can hear DXers Unlimited every week here on Radio Havana Cuba on the weekends and in the middle of the week.